Okay. Jill.
I'm sorry, but I don't feel, Jesse, like quite I understand why, what their objection is. Because, I mean, you're here to make sure that the businesses and the people inside it are safe. So what's the issue?
Currently, we're asking that in Monterey County, every city and agency or jurisdiction requires anything over 500 square feet to be sprinklered. That's not the case in the city of Salinas. The city of Salinas is anything over 5,000 square feet. So we're trying to get consistent with the other county agencies and cities. So that's what we're doing now. But as Dennis did mention, current economic times are such where it is a concern.
So are you saying it's an economic versus safety concern?
Well, that's what's going on right now. We would like to see it. We're recommending it. We are going to provide some alternatives for council to consider when we do present.
Yikes. Seems to me that safety and saving people's lives should be the priority.
Okay, let me.
Thanks.
Okay, the city manager.
Yeah, part of the issue here is that Jesse didn't have a chance to mention, but as you can recall, the council just recently approved the fire mitigation fee, which is quite financially onerous on businesses that are expanding their business in our city. And their concern is that, you know, adding additional financial burdens at this time on top, you know, subsequent to that recent increase would cause an undue burden to those businesses. And you guys can't see the look that Jill's giving me as I'm talking, so. but also to keep in mind, even though the cities in the outer part, I mean, of the county do have a lower restriction than we do, or threshold than we do for sprinkler improvements, a lot of those cities don't have the fire mitigation fee that we have, that we just recently passed as well. So we're just trying to make sure that we stay competitive in terms of the mandates that we put on businesses in terms of dealing with wanting to expand their businesses in our city. So, and what I've asked Jesse to do was to make sure that when we do hopefully reach a compromise with the Business Development Task Force, that we are not compromising public safety. So that will come back to you. I'm looking for a compromise that deals with the public safety side of it, but also takes into account that we don't want to do anything that might be perceived by the public as being non-business friendly.
And I appreciate that. I understand. I just, you know, this is a public safety issue, and I think that it's important that we actually mirror the standards of the county. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Jill. Anyone else? Okay, public want in on this? Okay, back to council.
Oh, yeah. Making a motion to approve.
I think.
Just need a motion to introduce.
Motion to introduce.
Second.
So we're only introducing. We're not committing to anything. It's just an introduction.
The first round.
It's not even like a date. It's just an introduction. seems pretty harmless. All right. Very good. Well, we are kind of a strange council. We can conclude with introductions. So we have just introduced, and we will now proceed to closed session, and the rest of that is really top secret stuff.
Thank
you.
So
we will be back next week. Thank you, everyone.